On today's episode of The Workshop, I'm going to be putting together the perennial favorite MPC's Ramchargers Challenger Funny Car. Hemi-powered Dodge Challenger in 1/25th scale will be the model. Check out the sweet retro photograph on there. Gives us a lot of decal options. Shows us the colors to paint the outside of everything. It should be a relatively easy build. Let's take a look at the parts that'll be in the box when you get yours. And I will link down in the description, as always, where you can snag yours on pre-order. First up are a nice set of Firestone Drag 500s. These look to be one-piece tires put together by Round 2. Big slicks on there. Excellent printing. If you want black walls, you can just use the other side. And then we have actual drag racing tires in the front. Denman front tires, just like the box says. They do have it imprinted on the sides. Nice tread pattern. These are nice and authentic, so that's pretty cool that those are in there. You can really get down and dirty if you want. We've got a nice set of glass here. One large piece. We're not doing much with the interior, so you don't have to worry about that kind of stuff. We have a good size chrome tree. A lot of this stuff will need to be painted anyways or decorated up in your own way. We've got a nice set of wheels on there. You can see how the wheels look on the box. So really the only chrome we'll be saving is the outer trim ring on the front wheel, it seems like. And that doesn't bother me. We'll have to cut those free and throw some paint. We got a front axle. We got part of our spool in the back end. We've got the cover for the spool, it looks like. Belt and pulley system. We'll need to paint that up. There's not a lot of chrome belts out there. We got our blower pieces. We've got our air intake for the blower. We've got linkages and steering. We've got our chrome valve covers for the race Hemi. So it's a nice enough chrome tree on there. Everything that we'll need. We've got a gorgeous decal sheet. Should make painting this car easy. You might not even have to paint the body itself because a lot of it is done for you on here. These decals actually have white in them. So you can see the difference between the light blue sheet and the white decal. Got the gorgeous 3D Ramcharger logos. Got the original scripts done up in three styles. As you can see, they would have changed the style over there for a while. So you could always do it, different scripts on everything. So you can do different generations of the Ramchargers Challenger. Lots of nice detail on there. Contingency decals. I like on this one here with like the Lunati decals and TRW. It's all one piece to do the part that comes up behind the fender. I'd like to see them do that for the ones that run down the bottom of the body, but they changed over time, so they do them individually for you on the sheet so you can match it up with the proper decals. That's it right there for those. On this side of the table, we've got white styrene for the body, which means you might not even have to paint the body if you didn't want to. We got the spoiler here as a separate piece. We've got what I'm pretty sure is the rear bumper as a separate piece. The rear body pan. Then we've got the entire Challenger Funny Car body itself. All the nice metal. There is actually, you can hear that. They've got the metallic stiffener to the body with rivets in it. Front of the car. See how very blocked off and blunt the front of the car is. Just like it is right from the box. Nice looking Challenger body on there. Blacked off in the back. It's a funny car. So everything would be done by decals. We have the interior of the body, which when it arrived was already inside and it seemed like it fit quite tightly. Put that in there. I mean, that fits in there really nice. Probably don't even have to glue that in there. That is a super, super, super duper nice fit. Like I said, look, I'm not even holding it in there. So that's cool. I like that. That'll make working on things a little bit easier. We've got two giant parachutes. Should you want to do this as a diorama where he's at the end of the track and the chutes are slowing him down. And if you want to know what color to paint them, there you go. Right there on the box. Shows you how to paint the chutes up. Should be easy enough with masking should you choose to use them. We've got our brace for the body in the front to hold the body up for our display. And whatever this part is, looks like a parachute mount for the back of the body. We've got more in black styrene, so we'll get it out here. We've got the chassis, which is nicely pre-built. Everything is angled. I really like that. It's hard for me to line these up properly as fast as I like to build. Here we've got a ramrod straight chassis, all built up, ready for paint, and done in black, so you probably don't even need to prime it in black like I like to. Got our zoomies coming out the side, pre-assembled. Got our fuel tank. Got these optional parts. I don't know what they are. I think they're listed in the manual, but they're in there. We've got our transmission or our clutch cover, our clutch housing. Got our wheelie bars. Interior with seat molded in. So you could technically paint this and just mask off the seat, and that's done for you. A lot of stuff pre-done on this, and I don't mind that at all. We've got our wheel backs here. That is solid plastic. You will have to cut that out. Looks like, is that a transmission tunnel or drive shaft tunnel? Got our roll cage, top of the roll cage. Got our axles, what I'm pretty sure are the axles for that spool. Body panels for the interior with nice rivet detail, very faint, but it's in there. And then we've got our halves to the Hemi, black. The engine's black. Got our folded parachutes. Got our brakes. And our engine cover on the front. And that is it, folks. That's all the parts that are in there. So I don't think this is going to be too difficult to build, but I shouldn't say that till I get to it. I'm going to start to throw glue at mine, and I'll be right back. Thank you. as I thought, or as I was hoping, this was going to be a relatively easy build so far, and it is extremely easy. No issues because of that frame is pre-molded in shape and lined up, and it's not warped. It just makes me so super happy. So we've got the body assembled. It takes a little bit to line up the bumper and the pan, but the instruction manual says that this is all white anyway. So if you want to fill that in or line it up a little better, you can see a little bit of a gap and stuff. If you're doing a super perfect show build, you'll want to spend a little time cleaning that up a little bit more, but mine are going to look just fine sitting on the shelf. Not a lot of people are going to be flipping it completely over and taking a look at it. So that's it. And then I attach the spoiler to the back. There really is no description on how far up or down the spoiler is, but looking at the box, it looks like it's pretty much straight up and down to give as much downforce as possible with the body and the small wing to make it resemble the Challenger. So that's how I glued it on, and it fit perfectly with no gaps. So that's where I'm guessing it should go. That's got a nice decal coming to it later. That'll go on that spoiler. This will go on the trunk lid. This will go on the roof. This stripe will go down the side of the body, front all the way to the back. So that's how I'm going to leave it. We're all cool with that. We don't have any issues. This part will be painted black according to the manual and then just snapped up inside. So that's awesome. That's the first time I've never had to actually build this part and try to line it up and attach it and all that stuff. It just snaps right in. So we'll get paint on both of those single colors and be done with them. The engine is together as far as I want to get it. Even though the engine is black, I still will put paint on it just to cover up any glue smudges and stuff. Then I will attach the oil pan and the valve covers and the blower and all that stuff, and I can hand paint the clutch and drive shaft tunnel and all that stuff like that. I can hand paint that, the steel engine cover. We can do all that with our lovely hand paints. Got the blower itself. You could leave it chrome, it goes together quite easily, or you could paint it. I'm going to paint it because I like different colors of metallics on my engine. The belt and pulley system definitely needs a coat of paint. Then I will use my metallic markers to get in there and do my pulleys up. I like how that turns out. We've got our zoomies or our headers. We're going to need to get those metallic painted. We've got our parachutes and our wheelie bars. The manual says leave those black, so we'll just get a coat of paint on them so they don't look like plastic. We got our body brace, our brakes. Those I want a metallic tone, same as the spool in the back end. I want this all a metallic tone, but not chrome, so those I can get all painted together. Same with the zoomies here with a nice metallic tone. We can put all those together. The wheel backs are black. All I have to do is cut out the centers. And part of the steering mechanism here is black, so I'm not really going to do anything with that. I'm just going to leave it and work on it as it is and be done with it in plastic. The rear wheels need to be painted to match the box art. They need to be painted a goldish color, a bronzish color, brass, whatever you want. Any kind of a gold color is going to work. The blower scoop goes together nicely without any hints of glue. You can super glue it all the way around the inside, and that will attach to the top of the blower easily. So that I'm going to leave chrome as it is. All I did was clamp it. And then our tree here, this I want to dull down. I'm going to spray some dulling agents on it to bring the shine of that chrome down, and then attach the parts to the car as we go. The insides of these wheels will need to be hand painted, and I can't wait to do that, make them look awesome. And that is it. So I'm going to get all of this stuff over to the paint booth. Except I almost forgot to do the chassis and the interior. So before I get to the paint booth, we've got our roll cage on and our two extension pieces. See how those come down and then straight out? You'll match those to the angle of this part or to your chassis. Those will go on. I did not attach anything else like the steering boxes or anything because I want to be able to get in here and deal with the seat after I get this all painted. You could mask it off, but I'm gonna like the look of a paint job on that seat, and I will do that by hand. We've got our chassis together. I don't want a chrome front axle or steering link. I want it to match the metallic blue of the chassis. Same as these side pieces, since they're all the same color. We'll just put them all in there at the same time. The fuel tank, according to the instructions, it's all metallic blue. So I have a blue ready. I don't even think I'll need to prime this, but maybe I will just to protect the plastic. Some of the spray paints I use might eat through styrene, so you always want to be careful. I glued the front axle on and the steering link with super glue. The metallic links here and the steering link, those I will leave in the metallic after I dull it and make it look nice. So now, after we test fit this in here, you can see how lovely that fits. all the way through without problems. Now I can hit the paint booth. Wrapping up, Ramcharger's funny car, their Dodge Hemi Challenger, a super easy kit to build with quite a few details, but not so many details that it starts to drive you absolutely insane with building and complicating it and all that. It's a lot of fun to build. I love these pad printed tires. The massive decal sheet allows you to produce a couple different Dodge Challengers from the Ramchargers, depending on which scheme or generation you wanted to go with. But overall, I went with the box art version, as good as I could get it with the decals, just from looking at the decals on here and the small decal guide in the manual, and produced the model you see here in only about 7 hours of total work. That's about it. I think that's about all I have into it over 2 days. Super easy. Things seem to line up for me. I mean, when I drop the body, it lines up with the blower on the engine. The interior drops right into the frame. I didn't have to fight the wheels or the axles from going on. The front one here is a little loose, but other than that, if you glued it on tighter than I did, you'd be fine. I like that they suggest the metallic blue. We've got the large stripes on the roof, which thankfully were white and red out of the box. They could have been clear and red too, and they would have worked just fine. But I use that gloss white from Krylon, matches those decals, looks good, and then you don't have to line up, you know, seven individual red stripes. The large red stripes down the side, you saw me apply the decals in the decal section. You saw how durable they were and how easy everything went on. Then we did the future floor polish on there in this video as well, so you saw how everything works and everything goes on nicely. I've shown final assemblies on dragsters before with this similar chassis, so I didn't show it in this one, but you can just look up any of the other MPC dragsters to see that. You can see how nicely detailed it is under there with that big old honking Hemi. And on this one, I was actually easily able to attach the breathers onto the valve covers, which sometimes I struggle with. I love the pre-built frame. Please do that and so many more. Obviously, these are reissues, but if they were going to improve some of the ones with the two-piece frames that are really hard not to build cockeyed, would be awesome if they had that pre-built frame in them. Makes life so much easier for a fast builder like me. Those pad-printed tires and those real drag tires on the front can't be beat. I did not build the parachutes off the back. That would have made for like a 2-foot diorama, which would look great on a shelf. I just did the parachutes glued to the back as if this car was sitting in the staging area back in the pit area so that everybody could look at it. I want to thank Round 2 Models again for sending this over. It is a beautiful kit, easy to build. The decals really make this kit. They really do. They're so nice. They've stepped up the quality of these decals in a lot of these kits. I used to have some problems years past with Round 2 Models decals cracking and busting up. These ones were so strong, I was worried about that thin stripe, and I can't say enough about how the decal quality has improved as the kits move on. Once again, thanks to all of you for watching the workshop. I always appreciate your likes, constructive comments, and ideas in the section. Subscribe. We have new videos coming out every single Wednesday and Saturday like we did today, and I will see all of you at the next review.